So welcome back. In the first session, we've been able to see a various percentage score when it comes to full expression. Full expression, reality, is a dynamics that shows you to what percentage you know your internal frameworks. Because in life, when you are not frameworked, you may not be able to mainstream. Mainstreaming is all about using what you have, who you are, to get what you want. And that is the journey of destiny which Jephthah made despite opposition. So we arrived at our various percentages and we're going on our clusters. And the first cluster is 0 to 39. If you score 0 to 39, then tick that cluster. You are in detention. And what does it mean? It means you've got no clue at all about yourself. I'm sorry to say, you are like a disaster going somewhere to happen. Prayers won't bail you out, prayers alone. You need to be spoken with, helped, so that you can face what is most important about yourself. So 0 to 39 cluster means you are completely clueless. You don't understand yourself. You do anything anyhow just for the fun of it. It means you have not been able to balance your activity, what you do, with your ability, what you have, given some certain realities there. So you need detention. We'll come back later. If you score from 40 to 50, tick attention. What does that mean? It means you are also not quite okay, just a bit different from the one who scores 0 to 39 there. So you are needing attention. You are also not understanding your purpose for living the way it should be. You are doing the wrong thing at the right time or the right thing at the wrong time. So you need help as well. If you score 51 to 60, well, that's a fair report, although in mediocrity. And what's the meaning? It means you understand your destiny a bit, where you are going and how to get there, but so many things you don't understand that still stands out. And that's the meaning of comprehension, meaning there are things you will have to comprehend in order to make the journey of destiny a great reality. If you score 61 to 70, you are needing manifestation. So what does that mean? It means that you know what you have, you know where you are going, but alas, so many hindrances, like Jephthah. You don't know how to go about those hindrances. So you are looking for platforms to manifest your talent, your quotient, your competencies, and your capacities. That's the meaning of manifestation. It means you have so many wishes that have not yet been manifested. That's the meaning of that score. If you score 71 to 80, you are in extension. Meaning, you know yourself, your internal wiring, where you are going, and possibly how to get there. But you have not attained full potential. So you need more platforms to extend and to stretch while you deepen your root. So you take your root down and spread further. That is the meaning. But when you score 81 and above. Wow! We're standing up for the champion there. It means you understand yourself so well. You are using your energies to maximum limit, exploiting all opportunities and fulfilling your potentials in your journey of destiny. It is then the School of Articulation, SABA Resources, who said, this is our beloved brother, beloved pastor, beloved sister, in whom the whole management is well pleased. We're going to recommend you to everyone in this conference in Cameroon this time around to say they should follow you because you are a model, you are in distinction. So those are the various meaning of those percentages is in cluster. And you know what? You can move from detention to distinction or model. The path of a just man is as the shining light that shines brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. So what do we do from here? You are in detention, don't worry. It's only to show you that you have journeys to make. You have things to do. You are in attention? Never mind. You are in comprehension or manifestation, or you are in extension or even distinction. You are not perfect yet. There are still loopholes you will need to block here and there so that you can reel out your full energies and competency from within. So what do we do and how do we know where your errors are in that errand of destiny? It is in four ways. That is where my competency comes in as a psychometrician. So what will you do? Snap your assessed copy to my WhatsApp number. My name is James. Snap it to +234 80 35 999 220. We will process it in our laboratory in Nigeria and send you 25 issues about your full expression. We'll tell you the good, the bad, and the ugly. You may want to know how we arrive at those reports. It's by four ways. One, structural deviation. Two, we are going to test you by what we call the rule of point blank analysis. Three, we're going to test you by root cause analysis and then by trend analysis. So snap your assessment and then snap the other one you were writing down. All the variables from point 1 to point 10. So you are snapping two things to me. And I assure you, we'll process it, get it back to you so that you can know yourself too well and see what to do, how to hit the ground running. Wow. So this is internal frameworks for external fireworks. I told you, Jephthah did two things in order to excel. What made Jephthah to be required was because, number one, he built internal frameworks. So you too can now build your own internal frameworks. And because of his framework, he will not fight nobody, but left for top. And in top, Some young men also came to him. He developed them. He deposited into them. Made them mighty giants who fought with him. Built a ground around his internal frameworks for external fireworks. So you see, it is framework inside for your fireworks outside. So what do you need to do in order to know and reckon with your assignment on a critical note? I will show you how to build your fireworks, your assignment. No alignment inside, no assignment outside. So now, the assessment you've just done is to show you your percentage alignment to who you are. And when you are not in full competence of yourself, knowing yourself, then you struggle. So it's not just about devil, devil, devil. You need knowledge. For my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So are you ready? We like to see how to perform your assignment. You see, you become phenomenal when you perform assignment based on your internal alignment. What do? You simply use what God has given you and how well you have developed yourself to create values in goods and services for others, either spiritual or otherwise. So life is out of order and a struggle. Of course, pressure when you have not found your own assignment. Your assignment is in your personal alignment, which you have just done. So we're going to do the second test now. Take it in your hand. It is called the Phenomenal Man Assessment Test, or the Phenomenal Woman Assessment Test. What is it all about? Now that we know your internal wiring, your giftings, your talents, your competencies, we know them. You have to be packaged in order to serve. Because in life, you have to be packaged to manage in order to avoid damage. You want to manage people, get packaged first. So I like to package you through the second assessment. And it is when you are packaged, you become phenomenal as a man or woman. So welcome to Phenomenal Man or Woman Assessment Test. Oh yeah, put your name again. Fill the details, your telephone number, your email address, your occupation. And please put your age. In the first test too, please put your age. We want to be precise in the analysis. Put your age. Now, we're going to apply the same principle. Please be very objective. Don't lie. We want to test for your level of phenomenon as an individual. So, the graph is still the same. One means what? Dull. Two, poor. Three, tolerable. Four, fair. Five, adequate. Six, good. Seven, very good. 8, excellent. 9, magnified. And 10, perfect. So that 1 to 10 for a graph is the same as that 1 to 10 in the column. It only tells us that 1 means that 1, dull. 2 means that 2, poor, for a graph. So are we ready? We want to test for phenomenon. It is your phenomenon that serves people, that deposits to people, that create wealth and solve problems, just as Jephthah did. Are we ready? Now question 1. How well do you understand your personal concept? Until you know yourself, you will never be original. So think. So what's the question saying? How well do you know yourself and accept your being a man or woman of your sort? No complex, whether inferiority or superiority. So tick yourself. Are you good? Are you excellent? Are you perfect? Whichever. Tick. And let's go. So put down the detail in another sheet of paper. Because you are going to snap all those details to me and wire you inside out and send you the report. So question two talks about personal content. It's not enough to accept yourself. You must carry some certain values inside. Develop yourself. I told you before, an empty sack will never stand. You have to put in something for it to be able to stand. So when you stand, it is because you contain something. So what do you carry? Do you develop yourself? So to what capacity have you developed yourself? So tick, that's content. He's asking how deep and strong within for a fundamental stand in life. You want to be a preacher, a music maker, an engineer? To what extent have you been able to develop yourself? Then number three, personal charms and courage. Is not enough to be wired inside in your makeup. You need to be charming. You need to be attractive. Very vital. So it's talking about how well do you appreciate your looks without complex. Very vital. How well are you charming? How attractive are you? Do you celebrate people? Do people like coming around you because there's something to tap into in your life? Very vital. Then number four is personal competence. How well do you build skills and develop your capacity for enlargement? What do you know? What can you fix? Put that down and then take the degree to such knowledge. Very vital. Then number five is personal concern. What is your concern? For the full life and not mediocrity. Very vital. How well do you desire the rounded and the comprehensive lifestyle? Concern for depth and dedication. Fix it. Because you see, when you don't show concern, you hardly will serve anybody. Then number seven is commitment. How well do you sacrifice and beef up the game of family members around you? Beginning from home. Charity begins at home. You want to serve? Showcase the example from your home first. So what's the level of your commitment to a family? You cannot serve a home, then you cannot serve church or serve society. So you need to understand that on a critical note. Then number seven is personal conscience. So what are we looking for here? How well do you have conscience towards God and other men or women alike? As to helping them to find fullness. Because service is helping others to run the race of destiny. So how well are you passionate in making others be exactly who they are meant to be? Very vital. So number eight is personal contribution. What we are asking of here is, how passionate are you to contribute to solving problems in Cameroon, everywhere you find yourself? How passionate are you? How well do you want to solve problems for people around you? And then number nine is personal cause. Jesus said, as long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. Do you have a mission statement? Do you have something that makes your energy to bulge? That's your personal cause. So how well can you say you stand up for something real in life to make all of the meaning? Because you see, friends, until you stand for something, you are going to fall for everything. So take yourself, how well? And what are those variables? And then number 10, personal contentment. What we're looking for here is, how well do you see yourself and accept your personal philosophy, your ideals? Are you there? Can you say you have fully developed yourself to that point where you become so admiring and attractive? So take yourself. Right. You've ticked 1 to 10 like we did in fit analysis. Calculate your percentage now. So how do we do it? Multiply the number of times you tick yourself in each column by the column number and write the answer in the black box down as category score for each of the column where you have ticked yourself. So look at it and multiply through. So if under column 2, score yourself 3 times, then you say 3 times the column number, which is 6, you put it right down in the category score, the black box down, the dark box. So have you done it? Add all the figures in the category score. Whatever you get is your percentage phenomenon. What's the meaning? It means currently you are that percentage ready to serve. Based on your internal wiring, you are that percentage ready. So what's the gap? What's the difference? You are going to tick your cluster also. You could be in detention, attention, comprehension, manifestation, extension, and model. Tick whichever cluster you belong. There's also a treatment for that through psychometrics and through the 4 variables of structural deviation, point blank analysis, root cause analysis, and trend analysis. And we combine the 4, it's going to tell us exactly your position now, your tendency now, where the loopholes are, so that you can cross your T and dot your I and become formidable. So I've shown you how to create your internal frameworks. And I have also shown you through phenomena, man or woman assessment test, how to package yourself for your assignment. Alignment inside, assignment outside. The 2 of them means journey of destiny, hitting the ground running in fulfillment. So snap the 2 to me through my telephone number +234 80 35 999 220 on WhatsApp. We'll write the report and brand you. So that is the behavioral revolution version of branding that we develop for Africans, so that as Africans we can rise and solve our problems ourselves through the potentials God has given us and through our personal activity to developing ourselves. I want to believe you made meaning, and these 2 assessments made meaning to you. Can you see what the grace of God can do just through reading scriptures we came up with assessment so that you not only read the scripture, you also do the scripture. So we've been able to do behavioral checkup from the neck up to see how far you have fared and to see where you need to work on yourself. I'd like to thank you so very much for making out this time to listen to this episode. Someday, somehow, we'll meet one-on-one and do more assessment there. Every challenge in life can be lined up to a particular assessment. And in the School of Articulation and Behavioral Alignment Resources in Nigeria, Abuja, precisely Federal Capital Territory of Nigeria, we've trained and graduated hundreds to showcase these competencies in various formats. We have addiction test, depression test. We work people out of suicide, and people on hypertensive lane have been worked out through psychometry, especially when it is not by heredity. Thank you so very much. I'm James Komolafe. We've done these competencies in blue chip companies, organizations, churches, institutions alike, just to intervene in societal problems. You have any question? You have platforms you want us to come? Just tell us the problem and the challenge. We'll create an assessment by which we can know exactly what is happening and how to move from where we are to where we are supposed to be. Thank you so very much. You want to reach me personally on my email address? You can reach me on my Gmail account. And my Gmail account is james1kom@gmail.com. I say it again, james1kom@gmail.com. My telephone number, I give it again. +234 80 35 999 220. That also doubles as my WhatsApp number. You want to follow me on Twitter? Follow me on Twitter at James1KOM, or just search for my name, James Komolafe. Our website for SABA resources is sabaresources.com. www.sabaresources.com. We have online programs and some of our books that will show you the comprehensive details of some of these competencies and learnings are available for you to buy on our website. Thank you so very much. God bless you. I expect to see your assessment. Cheers. Long live Federal Republic of Cameroon. Long live everyone out there in the youth camp. I love you all. God bless you. Cheers.